chapter 11, and we're going to consider verse number 7. This is a text that we visited last week.
Vamos a entrar al libro de Hebreos, capítulo 11, versículo 7. Es un texto que nosotros visitamos la semana pasada.
We're just going to read it for context, and then I'm going to bring a message in there. So, the book of Hebrews, chapter 11, verse 7, reads, by faith, by faith, Noah, being warned by God about things not yet seen, in reverence, prepared an ark. Say, prepared an ark. For the salvation, say salvation, of his household, by which he condemned the world and became an heir of the righteousness with which is according to faith.
Okay, Hebreos 11:7, por la fe, siendo advertido por Dios acerca de cosas que aún no se veían con temor, preparó una arca. Una vez más, él preparó una arca para la salvación de su casa, por lo cual condenó al mundo y llegó a ser heredero de la justicia que es según la fe.
Before the word is blessed, before you take your seat, look at your neighbor and ask him this question: can you be trusted to build in the dark?
La palabra es bendecida, pero antes de tomar asiento, mirad a tu vecino y preguntarle: ¿pueden confiar en ti para edificar en la oscuridad?
Come on, look at somebody, ask him the question: can you be trusted to build in the dark?
Mirad a alguien y hacerle la pregunta: ¿pueden confiar en ti para edificar en la oscuridad?
Oh, be seated. You may be seated. I promise you, this word is going to bless you.
Le prometo que esta palabra le va a bendecir. Pueden tomar asiento.
This word has already blessed me.
Ya esta palabra me ha bendecido a mí.
In this chapter.
En este capítulo.
You're trying to get it out.
Yeah,
because it's like stuck. It's stuck right in my throat. In this chapter.
En este capítulo.
The hall of the faithful.
El pasillo de los fieles.
We are presented with men and women.
Nosotros somos presentados con hombres y mujeres.
Who shined brightly.
Que brillaron.
Not like a diamond.
No okay. Como un diamante.
That's another song. For God in their dark world.
Sino que brillaron para Dios en este mundo oscuro.
Y'all hear what I said? They shined.
Escucharon lo que dijo. Ellos brillaron.
Bright.
De una manera que brillaron.
In a dark world.
En un mundo oscuro.
Somebody say dark world.
Alguien decide un mundo oscuro.
People who against all odds.
Las personas que en contra de todos la suerte.
Were able to overcome adversity and trial.
Subieron sobrepasar adversidad y las pruebas.
People who were able to bear a glowing testimony for the Lord.
Aquellos que pudieron tener un testimonio brillante. Para el Señor.
When others floundered in sin.
Cuando otros seguían cayendo en pecado.
In this great lineup of the faithful.
En esta línea de los fieles.
Could you imagine going to an event and the invited guests are this lineup of faithful people?
¿Tú te imaginas yendo a un evento y entonces los invitados especiales son esta gente que son personas fieles?
See Abraham.
Vemos a Abraham.
You get to see Noah.
Ves a Noé.
You get to see Rahab.
Puedes ver a Rahab.
Some of y'all be like, I want to see her, you know, but she was considered faithful.
Algunos tal vez dicen, ay, yo no la quiero ver a ella, pero sí también se considera ella una de las fieles.
He stood out in his day.
Él resplandeció en su día.
We're talking about Noah.
Estamos hablando de Noé.
Which was a man who shined brightly in the midst of a dark world.
Que es un hombre que brillaba de una en una manera en este mundo oscuro.
So he stood out.
Entonces
somebody say stand out.
Alguien resplandece.
So y'all don't want to stand out. Somebody say stand out.
Alguien dice resplandece.
It is this man named Noah that I want to dialogue about this morning.
Este hombre llamado Noé es el cual yo quiero dialogar esta mañana.
He possessed certain characteristics.
Él poseía ciertas características.
That we all need if we are to shine as he did.
En las cuales todos necesitamos si queremos brillar así como él lo hacía.
Now I understand that. That in his life he made mistakes.
Yo entiendo que en su vida él hizo errores.
But my conversation this morning is not about the mistakes he made.
Pero mi conversación esta mañana no se trata de los errores que él hizo.
But about the faith he had.
Sino de la fe que él tenía.
To be able to stand in the midst of a dark world
para poder estar de pie entre medio de un mundo oscuro
and fulfill what God has called us to fulfill.
Y cumplir lo que Dios nos llama a cumplir.
He tells us when we do,
Él nos dice cuando lo hacemos,
when we do what we're supposed to do,
cuando hacemos lo que debemos de hacer,
the world will take notice.
El mundo se va a dar cuenta.
Did y'all hear what I just said?
Escucharon lo que acabo
when
de decir.
We do what we're supposed to do,
cuando hacemos lo que estamos supuesto a hacer,
the world will take notice of you.
El mundo se va a dar cuenta de ti.
Did y'all hear what I just said?
Escucharon lo que acabo de decir.
Ain't nobody
decir.
Even saying amen to that. Okay, so when we do what we're supposed to
cuando
do,
hacemos lo que estamos supuesto a hacer,
the world will take notice of you.
El mundo se va a dar cuenta de ti.
Some of y'all be like, I ain't doing nothing, so you know the world ain't noticing me. But we're supposed to be being noticed by the world.
Estamos supuestos a ser que el mundo se dé cuenta de nosotros.
Come on now. So let's notice these characteristics as we talk about what I have as a topic for
Vamos
this
a notar
morning.
Estas características en lo que hablamos del tema de hoy.
Can we bless the Lord for Diana this morning in the back? Because I gave her a lot of verses and I know that she's probably like, you better read every single one for all
she
the work
She came up
you
to me, she's
do.
Like, look at this essay.
Yes, he's crazy. Okay, so we're going to be coming out of the book of Genesis chapter 6, and then we're going to land in Hebrews 11.
Vamos a comenzar en Génesis capítulo 6 y terminar en Hebreos 11.
If we were to read verses 5 to 8 of the first, of the sixth chapter in Genesis, I want you to listen carefully to what is being said in this text.
Vamos a leer versículos 5 al 8 en el capítulo 6 de Génesis y escuchar atentamente a lo que se está siendo dicho.
Then the Lord saw that the wickedness of mankind was great on the earth, and that every intent of the thoughts of their hearts was only evil continually.
Y el Señor vio que era mucha la maldad de los hombres en la tierra y que toda intención de los pensamientos de su corazón era solo hacer siempre el mal.
You do know that God gets angry.
Si saben que Dios se enoja.
And the world continues to do.
El mundo continúa haciendo.
And live like.
Y vivir como.
God is not in control.
Como que Dios no está en control.
You know, he gets angry.
Saben, él sí se enoja.
When the world continues to do the very things they do.
Cuando el mundo continúa haciendo las mismas cosas que hace.
When it's contrary to the design that God has built you for.
Cuando es contrario al diseño el cual Dios te edificó para él.
Verse number 6, so the Lord was sorry that he had made mankind on the earth, and he was grieved in his heart.
Versículo número 6, y le pesó al Señor haber hecho el hombre en la tierra, y sintió tristeza en su corazón.
Then the Lord said, I will wipe out mankind. Oh, Lord, have mercy. Come on, say, Lord, have mercy. You don't need to wipe nobody out right now, you know. So then the Lord said, I will wipe out mankind. This is Genesis 6, so don't be scared. Whom I have created from the face of the land, mankind and animals. I'm mad at the animals too, by the way, as well. And crawling things and the birds of the sky, for I am sorry that I have made them.
Y el Señor dijo, borraré de la faz de la tierra, no queremos que Él nos borre de la faz de la tierra, al hombre que Él ha creado, desde el hombre hasta el ganado, los reptiles y las aves del cielo. Ay, está enojado aún con los animales, porque me pesa haberlos hecho.
Come on now, that was good. I'm happy you're paying attention. Okay, and then verse number 8 says, watch this is powerful, but Noah found favor in the eyes of the Lord.
El versículo 8, escuchen, es bien poderoso. Dice, mas Noé halló gracia ante los ojos del Señor.
Come on, y'all, that's powerful. But Noah found favor in the eyes of the Lord.
Es bien poderoso. Mas Noé halló gracia ante los ojos del Señor.
First lady wants a flancocho. Did y'all hear that? That's what she says. She said, well, the flancocho. You know, poderoso.
If
come
anyone
on.
Knows how to make that really good, let me know.
Come on now. Stop. Stop throwing. Stop subliminally doing the commercials to see if somebody can bless you. But this is the crazy part. It's like when you watch a movie and something pops up
that.
And you're like, oh, I think I want ice cream.
So yo
that's
no dije
witchcraft.
Tú escuchaste flancocho. Tú quieres
okay.
flancocho.
Okay, so, but Noah found, see, you're not going to mess me up today because I'm connected what I'm doing. But Noah found favor in the eyes of the Lord.
Mas Noé halló gracia ante los ojos del Señor.
Previously to that, it says, then the Lord said, I will wipe out mankind.
Y antes de eso, el Señor había dicho, borraré de la faz de la tierra al hombre.
But Noah, I found you like a man that should receive favor.
Pero Noé, yo te encontré a ti como un hombre que debe de recibir favor.
So because I found you favorable,
entonces porque yo te encontré a ti favorable,
I'm going to give you an assignment.
Yo te voy a dar una asignación.
Before I fulfill this judgment,
antes de cumplir este juicio.
So I'm going to want you to do something.
Entonces yo voy a querer que tú hagas algo.
In the midst of this world that I'm tired of,
entre medio de este mundo en la cual estoy cansado de ella.
I'm going to give you grace.
Yo te voy a dar gracia.
Come on, somebody say grace.
Decir gracia.
So Noah was chosen by God.
Entonces Noé fue escogido por Dios.
So why did Noah alone find grace?
Entonces, ¿por qué fue que solamente Noé encontró gracia?
It's the mystery of election.
Es la, el misterio de la elección.
Because God looks upon the people.
Porque Dios mira sobre el pueblo.
He finds the ones that are serving him appropriately.
Él encuentra aquellos que le están sirviendo de una manera apropiada.
The ones that are praying right.
Aquellos que están orando de la manera
correcta. The ones that don't mess their time of worship.
Aquellos que no dañan su tiempo de oración.
They got their little prayer closet.
Tienen su armario de oración.
They got their Bible all highlighted.
Tienen su Biblia toda delineada.
If not the Bible, at least the YouVersion. App, the
si,
Bible app, you know, you got it highlighted.
Si no es la Biblia física, sino por lo menos la aplicación.
Because you know,
porque tú sabes,
that at some point God's gonna knock on your door.
Que en algún punto dado Dios va a tocar tu puerta.
And he's gonna say, I need you, son.
Y él te va a decir, te necesito,
I
hijo.
I need you, daughter.
Te necesito, hija.
There's an assignment I need you to fulfill.
Hay una asignación que necesito que cumplas.
There's something I need you to build.
Hay algo que necesito que edifiques.
Everyone is not available to build.
No todo el mundo está disponible para edificar.
But there'll be some that'll find faith.
Pero van a haber algunos que encuentran favor.
That will receive the secret of what's coming.
Que van a recibir el secreto de lo que está por venir.
Because there's something that's coming.
Porque hay algo que está por venir.
There's a revival that's coming.
Hay un avivamiento
there's
que está por venir.
There's a revolution that's coming.
Hay una revolución que está por
there
venir.
There are doors that are opening.
Hay puertas que se están abriendo.
And God is handing secrets to people.
Y Dios le está dando secretos a personas.
Secrets to prepare.
Secretos para preparar.
Secrets to prepare themselves mentally.
Secretos para prepararse mentalmente.
Fix themselves spiritually.
Para espiritualmente.
To connect to different streams of understanding.
Para conectarse a diferentes movimientos de entendimiento.
Because it's going to prepare them.
Porque le va a preparar.
For the moment he calls your number.
Para el momento que llame tu número.
So can I ask you a question? Have you found favor?
Entonces te puedo hacer una pregunta a ver si has encontrado favor.
Come on, just lie to me. Say amen.
Mentirme entonces y decir amén.
Remember, faith is declaring things that are not, you know. Just say yes.
La fe puedes declarar lo que no es.
Sometimes you gotta praise them ahead of time.
A veces tenemos que alabarlo antes de tiempo.
Y'all scaring me. Okay, so God looked at Noah and he believed that Noah had done enough to be spared by God.
Entonces Dios miró a Noé y él creía que Noé había hecho suficiente para que Dios no lo mate.
That's good enough. Okay, so
spared
this is
God.
The thing, though. So not just was he spared.
No solamente
el Señor lo salvó.
Le encontró gracia.
So watch this. So because he found favor.
Porque él encontró favor.
So everybody behind him.
Todos detrás de él.
Found favor.
Encontró gracia.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for that. Okay. So because he found favor,
entonces porque él tuvo favor,
his wife,
su esposa,
his children,
sus hijos,
his children's wives,
los hijos de sus
the wives of his children,
las esposas de sus hijos,
they found favor too.
Ellos también tuvieron gracia.
Okay. Because he found favor,
porque él encontró favor,
those that were connected to him,
aquellos que estaban conectados a él,
in his house,
en su casa,
also found favor.
También encontraron gracia.
That's why it's important for you to get your life right.
Por eso es importante que tú vayas a arreglar tu vida.
Because there are people behind you.
Porque hay personas detrás de ti.
That if you don't do it the right way, are not going to find that favor.
Que si tú no lo haces de la manera correcta, no vas a encontrar ese favor.
Look at your neighbor, say the work's on you.
Mira a tu vecino y decirle la obra está en ti.
And if we got children,
y si tenemos hijos,
we can't look at our children and tell them the work's on you.
Y no podemos ver a nuestros hijos y decirle el trabajo es tuyo.
The work's on me.
El trabajo es mío.
To make sure I find favor.
Y está sobre mí para yo
so that
favor,
they find favor.
Para que ellos encuentren
okay?
favor.
So you got to put some work in.
Entonces tienes que trabajar.
Okay. Look at your neighbor and say, put some work in.
Mira a tu vecino y decirle, tienes que trabajar.
So I'm looking around the building and I'm asking.
Estoy mirando alrededor del edificio y me estoy preguntando.
If anyone has found favor in the eyes of the Lord.
Que si alguien ha encontrado favor en los ojos del Señor.
Has anybody seen God begin to do some stuff that are a little weird?
Alguien ha visto a Dios que ha empezado a hacer cosas que son un poco raras.
That almost doesn't make sense.
Que como que no hace sentido.
That God is speaking some stuff that gets you a little bit scared on the inside,
Dios,
just a little bit.
Dios está diciendo algunas cosas que como que te asusta un poco adentro.
And you tell yourself, that's a little bit big.
Y tú dices, ah, es un poquito grande.
I don't think I'm gonna be able to do that.
Yo no creo que voy a poder hacer
But God
eso.
Is telling you, no, you got this.
Pero Dios te está diciendo, tú tienes esto.
I put favor on you.
Yo he puesto favor
to be able to walk in that season.
Para poder caminar en esa
temporada. To be able to walk in that glory.
Para caminar en esa gloria.
I'm here to tell you that the Father is looking.
Estoy aquí para decirte que el Padre está mirando.
Abba is looking for someone to release a word into.
Abba está buscando a alguien para desatar una palabra entre ellos.
That will change their world.
Que cambie su mundo.
That will change their season.
Que cambie su temporada.
That will change their life.
Que cambie su vida.
Because this is a critical hour.
Porque esta es una hora crítica.
Because he's calling us.
Porque él nos está llamando.
John 6:44. No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up on the last day.
Juan 6:44. Nadie puede venir hacia mí al menos que el Padre me llame a mí y lo resucitaré en el día final.
I promise you, I got all your verses. You don't have to paraphrase them. So watch this. He draws you in.
Él como que te ala hacia adentro.
Are y'all hearing me?
¿Escucharon eso?
In these moments of opportunity.
En estos momentos de oportunidad.
He's going to begin to draw people in.
Él va a empezar a jalar personas hacia
adentro. The Father is going to begin to look for people.
El Padre va a empezar a buscar personas.
Come. You come over here. Yep. Come closer.
Venid.
And that's what he's going to do. He's going to begin to pick people because what he's going to tell you to do is not going to make sense.
Él va a empezar a hacer eso, a buscar personas porque lo que te va a decir a ti como que no va a tener sentido.
And he needs to pick the right ones.
Y él tiene que escoger los correctos.
Because if he picks the wrong ones, he'll give excuses. I don't got the money. I don't think it's time.
Porque si él escoge los incorrectos se van a dar excusas. No tengo dinero, no tengo tiempo.
I'm not doing what I'm supposed to be doing.
No estoy haciendo lo que estoy supuesto a hacer.
And God is like, okay, excuse me. I knew I put favor on you, but you don't want it. Okay, fine. Let me get the next person.
Entonces Dios te empuja hacia el lado y dice, yo puse favor sobre ti, pero si tú no quieres, voy a buscar a la próxima persona. Porque esta próxima temporada va a requerir personas radicales
that will believe God.
Que van a creer a Dios.
That when God says, watch what I open up for you.
Que cuando Dios dice, mira lo que voy a abrir para
your
ti.
Legs might be trembling,
tus piernas tal vez están temblando.
But you're gonna walk trembling.
Pero tú vas a caminar temblando.
And you're gonna say, okay.
Y tú dices, ok.
I don't know how you're gonna do it.
Yo no sé cómo lo vas a hacer.
But I'm ready to look like a fool.
Pero estoy listo para verme como un tonto.
Because you called me for this
porque tú
hour.
Me has llamado para esta hora.
You drew me in.
Porque me alaste hacia dentro.
Look at your neighbor and say, your Father's looking for you.
Mirad a tu vecino y decirle, tu Padre te está buscando.
And you want to know why we should be available?
Y quieres saber por qué debemos estar disponibles.
Ephesians chapter 2 verse 1 says, and you were dead in your offenses and sins.
Efesios 2:1 dice, y él os dio vida a vosotros que estabais muertos en vuestros delitos y pecados.
Did y'all hear what I just said? You were.
Escucharon eso, estaba.
This is why I should be available.
Por esto es que debo de estar disponible.
Because you were.
Porque estaba.
So he took you out of your offenses and your sin.
Entonces él te sacó de tus ofensas y tu pecado.
And he drew you in.
Y él te entró.
So that he can give you
para que él te pueda dar
a word that's about to change everybody behind you.
Una palabra que va a cambiar a todo el mundo detrás de ti.
It's going to protect you.
Te va a proteger a ti.
But it's going to start a new season.
Pero va a empezar una nueva temporada.
Look at your neighbor.
Mira a tu vecino.
And say he freed me for a reason.
Y decirle, él me liberó por una razón.
Come on, say he freed me for a reason.
Él me liberó con una razón.
He freed me for a reason.
Me liberó con una razón.
Watch this. Ephesians chapter 1 verse 4 says, just as he chose us in him before the foundation of the world that we would be holy and blameless before him in love.
Efesios 1:4 dice, según nos escogió en él antes de la fundación del mundo para que fuéramos santos y sin mancha delante de él en amor.
He predestined us to adoption as sons and daughters through Jesus Christ to himself according to the good pleasure of his will.
Otra vez, en amor nos predestinó para adopción como hijos para sí mediante Jesucristo conforme el beneplácito de su voluntad.
Beneplácito, that's a good word. Come on, look at somebody, say I'm a son. If you're a girl, say I'm a daughter.
Mirad a alguien, decirle soy hijo o hija.
Come on, somebody declare declare that. Say, I got the benefits.
Alguien declarar eso, yo tengo los beneficios
of being a child
de ser un hijo,
of the
hija
Most High God.
Del Dios Altísimo.
Come on, tell somebody I got backup.
Yo tengo respaldo.
Because my daddy got me.
Porque mi papá me respalda.
Because my daddy saved me.
Porque mi papá me
My daddy
salvó.
Delivered me.
Mi papá me liberó.
And my daddy is about to use me.
Y mi papá me va a usar.
Come on, look at somebody and say, I'm powerful because I'm a child.
Mira a alguien y decirle, soy poderoso porque soy hijo.
I was broken.
Estaba quebrantado.
But he fixed me up.
Pero él me arregló.
I was a sinner.
Él era un pecador.
But he forgave me.
Pero él me perdonó.
I was lost.
Estaba perdido.
But he found me.
Pero él me encontró.
And then he gave me a word.
Y entonces me dio una palabra.
And he said, change the world.
Y él dice, cambia el mundo.
Look at your neighbor and say, God is choosing.
Mira a tu vecino y decirle, Dios te está escogiendo.
Because many are the called.
Porque muchos son los llamados.
But few are the chosen.
Pero poco los escogidos.
You see, many are the called. Many come to church and they are called.
Muchos vienen a la iglesia y son llamados.
And that's okay.
Y eso está bien.
Because we're going to get to heaven.
Porque vamos a ir al cielo.
But then there are those few.
Pero entonces hay pocos.
That they tell God, this is boring.
Que le dicen a Dios, esto es medio aburrido.
Can I do a little bit more?
Puedo hacer un poquito más.
And God's like, really?
Y Dios dice, ¿de verdad?
He says, okay, I'm going to change your name from called to chosen.
Y entonces él dice, voy a cambiar tu nombre de llamado a escogido.
Now that you want to be chosen,
ya que tú quieres ser escogido,
you done asked persecution.
Tú has pedido persecución.
Hate.
Odio.
Anger,
enojo,
from the world,
del mundo,
to literally come after you.
Para literalmente venir detrás de ti.
Because chosen folk shift things.
Porque las personas escogidas cambian las cosas.
Okay, chosen folk change paradigms.
Las personas escogidas cambian las paradigmas.
The chosen folk,
las personas escogidas,
establish things.
Establecen cosas.
Oh my God! So if you want to shift from one to the other,
entonces si quiere cambiar o mover de uno al otro,
you gotta get ready.
Tienes que preparar.
For what's happening on the outside after, during the time that you build.
Por lo que va a ocurrir afuera durante el tiempo que edificas.
Because as you're chosen,
porque en lo que tú eres escogido,
you gotta build as people watch.
Tienes que edificar en lo que las personas están
and
mirando.
They're gonna tell you,
y te van a decir,
why are you building?
¿Por qué estás edificando?
When there's nothing around that tells me,
cuando nada está alrededor que me dice,
that you should be building that.
Que tú debes estar construyendo eso.
But you don't need to respond to that.
Pero tú no tienes que responderle a eso.
Because the instructions were given to you.
Porque las instrucciones se fueron dadas a ti.
The assignment was put on you.
La asignación fue puesta sobre ti.
Oh, not somebody and say that assignment is on you.
O tocar a alguien y decirle esa asignación está sobre ti.
Because you've been chosen by God.
Porque tú has sido escogido por Dios.
Is there anybody here that can declare I'm chosen?
Puede alguien declarar soy escogido?
That's only a few, y'all.
Solamente algunos.
You know, after I gave the job description, some of y'all changed your mind.
Después que di la descripción del trabajo, algunos como que cambiaron su mente.
I'm good, deuces. I don't mind praising you, God.
Yo estoy bien.
But I don't need nobody coming after me.
Yo estoy bien solamente adorante. Yo no necesito.
I don't need the world hating me.
Yo necesito que alguien venga detrás de mí o el mundo que esté odiándome.
I'm still trying to get my relationship with my family right.
Todavía estoy tratando de arreglar mi relación con mi familia.
But if you want to be chosen,
pero si quieres ser escogido.
Abba is looking.
Abba está buscando.
Did y'all hear me? Abba is looking.
Abba está buscando.
For people,
por personas,
that'll say yes to his voice.
Que digan que sí a su voz.
Did y'all hear what I said?
Escucharon lo que dije.
They'll say no to their voice.
Ellos dicen no a su voz.
And they'll say yes to his voice.
Y entonces le dicen sí a su
that
voz.
Mean all these preconceived thoughts that I have in my head.
Eso quiere decir todos esos pensamientos preconcebidos que yo tengo
en
mi cabeza.
I need to tell Danny to shut up.
Yo tengo que decirle a Danny que se silencie.
And say God talk.
Y decir Dios,
puedes
hablar.
I'll be quiet.
Yo voy a mantener silencio.
And I'll listen to what you gotta say.
Y voy a escuchar lo que tú tienes que decir.
Because your words are more important than mine.
Porque tus palabras son más importantes que la mía.
Come on, do you know you get in the way?
Tú sabes que tú estás eres un estorbo.
You know you get in the way of God's movement?
Sabes que a veces eres un estorbo en el movimiento
when
de Dios.
When Abba shows up and he knocks on your door and he tells you I'm gonna do this in your life, you be like and you delay it for a whole month.
Cuando Abba aparece y él toca tu puerta y tú empiezas a quejarte y entonces tú lo delatas por un mes.
But don't worry about it. Declare me, I'm chosen.
Pero no te apures, yo voy a declarar que yo soy escogido.
Y'all scaring me. Come on, declare me, I'm chosen.
Declar conmigo, decir y soy escogido.
Am I talking to the church or what?
Le estoy hablando a la iglesia, okay.
So everybody should be declaring I'm chosen.
Todos deben estar declarando soy escogido.
I'm about to get an apostolic anger.
Me voy a tener un enojo apostólico.
I'm just mad, just looking at folk, looking at me funny, like y'all don't know what it feels like to be chosen.
Me están mirando como que no saben cómo se siente ser escogido.
Déjame relajarme, cuidado. So in the book of I'm sweating a lot. I feel it. It's like I'm burning.
It's in your eyes.
I know it's crazy. I can see all right, though. Okay, calm down. My eyebrows, those are my sponges. My eyebrows are the towels. Don't you notice it never gets into my eyes, okay? Then y'all don't understand. I look great up here, though. Down on the floor, though. Look close. Genesis chapter 7, verse 1. I want you to listen to this verse, really key. It's very key. Then the Lord said to Noah, watch this, enter the ark.
Génesis capítulo 7, versículo 1. Escuchen atentamente. Entonces el Señor le dijo a Noé, entra en el arca.
You almost said Jonah. You are, you and all your household, for you alone, I have seen, watch this, for I have seen to be righteous before me in this generation.
Entra en el arca tú y todos los de tu casa, porque he visto que solo tú eres justo delante de mí en esta generación.
I wasn't told about you.
No me han dicho de ti.
Nobody tweeted about your name.
Nadie escribió en los medios sociales de tu nombre.
I saw you.
Yo te vi a ti.
I observed you.
Yo te observé a ti.
In this generation.
En esta generación.
That's a big deal.
Es algo
so
grande.
Since I observed you.
Entonces porque te observé.
I'm asking you to enter.
Yo te estoy pidiendo que entres.
Okay, what? This is the crazy part.
Esta es la parte la locura.
He's asking him to enter into something he built.
Él te está pidiendo que entres a algo que él edificó.
So I built it.
Entonces yo lo edifiqué.
I expect to be able to come in.
Yo espero te poder entrar.
But still there's an invitation.
Pero todavía hay una invitación.
Because there could have been a possibility.
Porque podía haber una invitación.
That he might have told himself, I don't really need to go in there. This don't make no sense.
Que tal vez se diga, yo no tengo que entrar ahí, como que no tiene sentido.
I'm still going to give you the option.
Todavía te puedo dar la opción.
Did y'all hear what I just said? He gave you a word.
Él te dio una palabra.
On what's coming.
En lo que está por venir.
He told you.
Él te dijo.
What needs to be done.
Lo que tiene que ser hecho.
To overcome what's coming.
Para poder sobrepasar lo que está.
But he still gave you an opportunity.
Pero él todavía te dio una oportunidad.
To say yes or no to entering the ark.
Para decir sí o no para entrar al arca.
And I'm telling you, you can enter.
Y te estoy diciendo que puedes entrar.
Because I've watched you.
Porque yo te he velado.
I've observed your behavior.
Yo he observado tu comportamiento.
I've watched how you talk.
Yo he velado cómo estás hablando.
I've watched how you walk.
Yo he velado cómo estás caminando.
I've watched how you act at work.
Yo he velado cómo actúas en el trabajo.
I've watched how you talk to your friends.
Yo he velado cómo estás hablando con tus amistades.
I've watched how you behave in the dark.
Yo he velado como tú te compartas en la oscuridad.
And because
y porque
you've done well,
tú has hecho bien.
I invite you.
Yo te invito
to enter it.
Que entres.
There's a tenderness to that invitation.
Hay una ternura a esa invitación.
And God is the perfect gentleman, so he's not going to force you to come into nothing you don't want to come into.
Y Dios es un caballero perfecto, él no te va a forzar a entrar a algo que tú no quieres.
So he calls.
Entonces él llama.
But man has to answer.
Pero el hombre tiene que responder.
Y'all hear me? He calls, but man has to answer.
Él llama, pero el hombre tiene que responder.
You are invited to enter the thing you built.
Tú estás invitado a entrar a lo que tú edificaste.
You are invited.
Tú estás invitado
to enter the thing you worked for.
A entrar por lo que tú trabajaste.
The thing you sweated for.
Por lo cual sudaste.
The thing that as you built it, people were laughing at
you. Aquello que en lo que tú estabas edificándolo, las personas estaban riendo
as
de ti.
As you built it.
En lo que tú lo construiste.
People were watching you.
Las personas estaban mirando.
And cracking up.
Y riéndose.
As you built this boat for water you've never seen.
En lo que tú construiste este barco para agua que tú nunca has visto.
I don't know what I'm doing.
Yo no sé lo que estoy haciendo.
But I know that God told me.
Pero yo sé que Dios me dijo.
To build an ark.
Que edifique un arca.
I don't know what's coming.
Yo no sé lo que está por venir.
I've never even seen what he said is coming.
Yo nunca he visto lo que él dice que está por venir.
But one thing I know.
Pero una cosa que yo sé.
I gotta keep on building.
Es que tengo que seguir construyendo.
I know that people outside the boat are laughing.
Yo sé que personas fuera del arca se están riendo.
But I'm inside the boat.
Pero estoy dentro del arca.
And I've been given the instructions.
Y me han dado las instrucciones.
So I gotta keep on building.
Entonces tengo que seguir edificando.
I gotta build in the dark.
Tengo que edificar en las tinieblas.
Where nobody's watching you.
Donde nadie te está mirando.
Where nobody's asking for you.
Donde nadie está preguntando por ti.
Where nobody's looking your name up.
Donde nadie está buscando tu nombre.
But you're building in the dark.
Pero estás edificando en la
oscuridad. You're preparing yourself.
Te estás preparando.
For the moment that God opens that door.
Para el momento que Dios abra esa puerta.
That you say.
Que tú digas.
God, I'm ready.
Dios, estoy listo.
I've done this.
He hecho esto.
I've done that.
He hecho aquello,
I've done this.
He hecho esto,
I've done that.
He hecho aquello,
because I prepared the invitation.
Para la invitación.
I don't know how many are eager to be invited.
Yo no sé cuántos están animados para ser invitados.
But I know I want to be invited.
Pero yo sé que yo quiero ser invitado.
So Noah.
Entonces Noé
comes to God.
Viene hacia Dios.
Watch this, verse number 7.
Mirad esto, versículo número 7.
And Noah and his sons and his wife and his sons' wives with him entered the ark.
Entonces entró Noé en el arca y con los hijos y su mujer y las mujeres de sus hijos entraron al arca.
Because of the waters of the flood.
A causa de las aguas del diluvio.
Now let's be honest, the water hadn't come yet.
Vamos a ser honesto, el agua no había llegado todavía.
So I'm gonna come in.
Entonces yo voy a entrar.
Because I'm getting ready.
Porque me estoy preparando.
To survive.
Para sobrevivir.
Getting ready to survive this season.
Estoy preparando para sobrevivir esta temporada.
So the Lord let me build.
Entonces el Señor dejó que yo edifique.
In a dark place.
En un lugar oscuro.
To survive.
Para sobrevivir.
Another dark place.
Otro lugar oscuro.
But you know what?
Pero sabes qué?
As I've built.
En lo que yo he edificado.
I've been alone anyway.
Yo he estado solo como quiera.
So as I wait,
entonces en lo que espero,
inside the ark,
dentro del arca,
I've learned how to process.
Yo he aprendido cómo procesar.
How it feels like to just be around my family.
Cómo se siente solamente estar alrededor de mi familia.
How to pray with them.
Tuve que orar con
how
ellos.
How to worship with them.
Tuve que adorar con
how
ellos.
How to slap them up when they get on my nerves.
Cómo corregirlo
no,
cuando
do
me enojan.
Remember, you don't do that. You talk to them, have conversation. You pray over
tiene
them.
Tiene conversaciones
anoint
con ellos,
them
oraciones
with oil.
Con ellos.
Okay.
But
I'm okay.
Pero estoy bien.
But you're not able to do that unless you enter.
Pero tú no puedes hacer eso al menos que tú puedas entrar.
The instruction.
Las instrucciones.
Catch it.
Entended.
The instruction is not just for Noah.
Las instrucciones no son solamente para Noé.
Catch it.
Entended.
He said.
Él dice.
You.
Tú.
Your wife.
Tu esposa.
Your children,
tus hijos,
and the other ladies,
y, las
and
otras
the
personas,
wives of your sons,
las otras personas,
the extras,
las extras.
We can bring them too. I don't like that one, but you know, you go bring them. You chose
no me gusta esa, pero la puedes traer porque tú la escogiste.
You know, bring them in.
Que la entres.
The assignment,
la asignación,
is approved.
Está aprobada.
When you follow through,
cuando tú sigues,
with the instructions,
las instrucciones.
Because you can't choose.
Porque tú no puedes escoger.
If he's already given you instructions.
Si él ya te ha dado instrucciones.
Did y'all hear what I just said? You can't choose what you want.
Tú no puedes escoger lo que tú quieres.
If he's already given you.
Si ya él te ha dado
instructions.
Instrucciones.
Okay. There's no reason to change the instructions.
No hay razón para cambiar las instrucciones.
If he already gave them to you.
Si ya él te la dio a ti.
Maybe he got confused.
Tal vez él se confundió.
And he didn't mean that.
Y él no quiso decir
follow
eso.
The, somebody say follow the instructions.
Alguien dice seguid las instrucciones.
So Noah,
entonces Noé,
took the step of faith that saved his soul and his family.
Él tomó el paso de fe que salvó su alma y su familia.
Up to that moment,
hasta ese punto,
he could have walked away.
Él podía irse.
Do you know how many people,
¿sabes cuántas personas,
have been at the door of their biggest breakthrough?
Han estado en la puerta de su quebrantamiento más grande.
And what they chose to do.
Y lo que escogieron hacer.
Is to walk the other way.
Es caminar al otro lado.
They were right there.
Estaban ahí mismo.
And they turned over.
Y dieron la vuelta.
And they walked away.
Y caminaron fuera de ella.
Up to the last moment they had a choice.
Hasta el último momento tenían una opción.
And you know what happens?
¿Y sabe lo que ocurre?
If he would have done that.
Si él hubiera hecho eso.
His works would have meant nothing.
Sus obras no querían decir nada.
The hours of tears and frustration.
Las horas de lágrimas y frustración.
Would have meant nothing.
No hubieran quisiera decir nada.
The craziest thing is that you invest money on something.
La locura es que tú inviertes dinero en algo.
And then you lose it all.
Y entonces lo pierdes todo.
It's like I don't mind because I believe it's a good thing when people invest in the stock market.
Creo que es algo bueno cuando las personas invierten en el stock market.
La bolsa de moneda, creo que la bolsa de moneda.
De valores.
De valores.
Yes.
I'll
yes.
take moneda, la casa de papel. So watch that if you haven't seen it. Okay, so a money heist. So it is an up and down roller coaster.
Es como una montaña rusa que va sub y baja.
You can invest.
Puedes invertir.
And you hope that your money gets a return.
Y tienes una esperanza de que tu dinero te devuelvan
But
algo.
But something can happen to that company.
Pero algo le puede ocurrir a esa compañía.
And you can lose all your money.
Y puedes perder todo tu dinero.
When you invest what you got, thinking that you were going to make more money, and what you did was lose it.
Cuando tú inviertes lo que tú piensas, pensando que tú vas a hacer más dinero, y entonces lo pierdes.
I plead. With you.
Yo oro contigo.
Le ruego that if you're at the door,
le ruego que si estás en la puerta,
don't turn,
no vayas a voltearte,
and look in the other direction.
Y mirad en la otra dirección.
Go in.
Entrad.
Inside the thing you built. Go inside the thing you built.
Entrad adentro de lo que tú edificaste.
You put time.
Tú pusiste tiempo.
You put sweat.
Sudaste.
You put tears.
Pusiste
you put frustration.
Lágrimas y frustración.
Enter into that season.
Entrad a esa temporada.
Because that season is supposed to cover you.
Porque esa temporada está supuesto cubrirte.
That season is supposed to cover you.
Esa temporada está supuesto cubrirte.
It's going to cover you from the flood.
Te va a cubrir del
It's going to cover you from the storm, del diluvio.
Del diluvio y de la tormenta.
It's going to cover you from the wind.
Te va a cubrir de los vientos.
It's going to cover you from the rain.
Te va a cubrir de
You might not see the sun,
tal vez tú no veas el
but
sol,
at least you're going to be covered.
Pero por lo menos va a estar
because
cubierto.
What you built was prepared to cover you.
Porque lo que tú edificaste está preparado para cubrirte.
For this season
para esta temporada.
Has been prepared for your exposure.
Y ha sido preparada para que tú seas expuesto.
I hear me today because God is doing it for his people.
Porque Dios lo está haciendo para su pueblo.
Oh, it's an open season.
Es una temporada abierta.
And it is an open door.
Y es una puerta abierta.
For by grace you have been saved through faith.
Porque por gracia tú has sido salvo por fe.
And this is not of yourselves. It is the gift of God.
Y esto no es de vosotros, sino que es don de Dios.
Not a result of works.
Y no por obras.
So that no man may boast.
Para que nadie se glorie.
So I do it because I could do it because he allowed me to do
Entonces,
it.
Entonces yo lo hago porque él lo pudo hacer porque él me permitió hacerlo.
So these steps led them to salvation.
Entonces estos pasos lo llevó a la salvación.
The salvation of His family.
La salvación de su familia.
So let's go to verse number 9, Ms. Diana. It says, these are the records of the generations of Noah. Watch this. Noah was a righteous man. Say righteous man.
Righteous man. 6:9.
Blameless in his generation. Say blameless. And Noah walked with God.
Génesis 6:9 lee, en estas son las generaciones de Noé. Noé era un hombre justo, perfecto, entre sus contemporáneos, Noé andaba con Dios.
Sorry. Listen to this.
Escuchad esto.
Noah had a positional sanctification.
Noé tenía una santificación de posición.
If you can lead, thank you for leaving the English version up. It declared that he was a man that was righteous.
Declararon que era un hombre justo.
Did y'all hear that? He was a man that was righteous.
Escucharon un hombre justo.
Declared holy.
Declarado santo.
Declared just.
Declarado justo.
By the decree of God.
Por el decreto de Dios.
This blessing belongs to every child of God.
Esta bendición le pertenece a todo hijo de Dios.
Every child of God.
Todo hijo de Dios.
It belongs to every child of God.
Pertenece a todo hijo de Dios.
Thank you. I don't know whether I'm a church service or a funeral. You know, talk to me, y'all. It belongs to you.
Te pertenece a ti.
And I say you got $1 million, and y'all gonna be like.
$1 million.
Man, I'll be running. I'll be shouting. I'll be getting it. Listen. Yesterday we went to I think it's called Bury the Hatchet, right? For Abdiaz's 40th. And you gotta throw these axes right into the bullseye.
Ayer fuimos a un evento del cumpleaños de Abdiaz, que cumplió 40 años, y entonces teníamos que tirar el hacha.
Yes.
El hacha y darlo al blanco.
Pastor was the pro. Like, he's the general. He was, like, standing like this, mad, you know, strong, and he's, like, squeezing his arm really tight and stuff, and then he was throwing, right?
Yeah, you were.
Yeah, you were. It was crazy. He was like, Every time he would throw, it was a pose. I felt that he thought that there was cameras taking pictures, but he was like, right? Like he's focusing and stuff.
Siempre que tiraba el hacha como que estaba modelando.
We don't want to.
Y se enfocaba y entonces siempre.
We definitely don't want to talk about the other side of the spectrum, Joanna. We're gonna not talk about Joanna. I don't know what she was doing. I think she wanted to kill everybody. So, but the thing is, I waited for like 10 minutes.
La cosa es que yo esperé como por 10 minutos.
Because I got really nervous.
Porque yo me puse bien nervioso.
Because I was telling myself, Danny, you gonna suck.
Like, porque yo me estaba diciendo a mí mismo, tú vas a ser horrible.
This is gonna be embarrassing.
Esto va a ser vergonzoso.
They would ask me to go, and I'm like, you know, I'm just processing. I'm observing.
Y me pedían que vaya, yo decía, no, estoy procesando.
So I get up there to grab that axe. And I'm like, I don't know what I was doing. That thing was just going downward. It was not going. It
cuando
was
hitting the bullseye. Hacha, siempre como que se caía, no sabía lo que estaba haciendo.
And I felt like dumb, like because it's really close, right?
Y yo me sentía bien tonto porque como que está bien cerca el blanco.
This dude comes up and he says, "We're gonna do this thing, and if you hit the bullseye, you're gonna get a T-shirt. If not, you're gonna get a wristband."
Entonces viene un chico por ahí y dice, oh, si le da el blanco, te vamos a dar una camiseta, y si le da otro lugar, entonces te vamos a dar un wristband.
Everybody's going, and they're all missing.
Todo el mundo está yendo, y ellos todos... No,
so I expected the... I got to say the face.
Yeah.
I expected the general...
Yo esperaba que el general...
To do it, so he gets up there, and everybody's watching, because nobody's even moving, and he's like...
Y todo el mundo está mirando y estamos mirando
like
el general.
I'm
ahí.
Like, who you looking at? Like that's there ain't nobody over there. It's just a bullseye. Like who you looking at like that? You know, so Matt focuses and he throws it and he misses.
Él la tira y entonces como que no le da al blanco.
So I said they said, oh, you said, oh, Danny hasn't gone. Danny hasn't gone. And I was like, no, I went on this side.
When nobody was
and
looking.
I missed when nobody was looking. I said,
y yo dije,
I went.
No, ya yo lo hice cuando nadie estaba mirando y no.
And they were like, no, you gotta do it over here. I'm like, dang, man, I don't wanna do it.
Y yo dije, no, yo no lo quiero hacer porque ahora me van a mirar.
Why, this is so embarrassing. So I just stand there like
es tan
this.
Vergonzoso, yo me
and
paré
like,
ahí.
Dios mío, esto, it's going to be horrible. Everybody's watching.
Y ahora todo el mundo
I
me está mirando,
it,
la tiré.
And that thing hit the bullseye.
Y yo le di al blanco.
I saw it, I was like, ah! I was screaming, I didn't know what to do. Because I got a T-shirt. That's
vi,
a big deal.
Empecé a gritar, no sabía qué hacer, qué emoción. Ahora tengo una camiseta.
Like, I was screaming like I don't want $1,000,000.
Yo grité como que gané $1,000,000.
I was like, oh, my God.
Yo dije, ay, Dios mío.
I outdid everybody. And I wasn't even the general. You know, but this is what happens.
Esto es lo que pasa.
You know, we only get excited
solamente nos emocionamos
when we see the thing happen.
Cuando vemos que la cosa ocurre.
And we don't get excited on the process of it happening.
Y no nos emocionamos en el proceso que
and
está ocurriendo.
All my horrible misses from there on forward meant nothing because I hit the bullseye.
Después de ahí en adelante, todo lo que fallaba no quería decir nada porque ya yo le di al blanco.
And God is working with us.
Dios está obrando con nosotros.
To figure out if we are excited.
Para ver si nosotros estamos emocionados.
That we have been chosen.
De que hemos sido escogidos.
To walk in a season.
Para caminar en una temporada.
As blameless and righteous.
Sin culpa y justos.
No, okay. Some of y'all want to keep on walking as sinners. Okay, I got it. So we got to tell ourselves, I want to be righteous.
Entonces tenemos que decir nosotros mismos que quiero ser justo.
And I want to be blameless.
Y quiero ser encontrado sin culpa y perfecto.
If I can just read verse number 9 of 1 Corinthians chapter number 6, just verse number 11. Such were some of you, and this is talking about a whole bunch of things in that chapter that we were, okay? But you were washed. Say washed. Uh-huh. Watch this. You were what? Sanctified. Say sanctified. And you were justified in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and in the Spirit of our God.
1 Corintios 6, versículo 11. Y esto erais algunos de vosotros, pero fuisteis lavados, una vez más lavados.
Yeah.
Pero fuisteis santificados, una vez más santificados.
Yeah.
Pero fuisteis justificados, una vez más justificados. Uh-huh. En el nombre del Señor Jesucristo y en el Espíritu de nuestro Dios.
You have been declared clean.
Tú has sido declarado limpio.
Okay, all right. You've been declared clean.
Así sido declarado limpio.
That makes me available.
Eso me hace disponible.
To be invited into the ark.
Para ser invitado en el arca.
That makes me available.
Eso me hace disponible.
To hear the instruction on how to build the ark.
Para escuchar la instrucción de cómo edificar el arca.
That makes me available.
Eso me hace disponible.
To hear the secrets on what's coming.
De escuchar los secretos de lo que está
on
por
why
venir.
I'm building the ark.
En por qué estoy edificando el arca.
Come on, because when we start building, God already gave you a secret.
Porque cuando ya empezamos a edificar o construir, ya Dios te dio un secreto.
When you start preparing, God gave you a secret.
Cuando empiezas a declarar, ya Dios te dio un secreto.
That means God is telling you.
Eso quiere decir que Dios está
there's
diciendo.
There's something I'm releasing in your favor.
Hay algo que voy a soltar a tu favor.
That requires for you to build this way.
Que requiere que tú vayas a edificar de esta manera.
Everybody doesn't need to be on board.
No todos tienen que estar en la misma página.
But you gotta build.
Pero tú tienes que edificar.
Look at your neighbor. I gotta build because I've been made clean.
Mira a tu vecino y decirle tengo que edificar porque yo he sido limpio.
I no longer have to call myself dirty.
Ya yo no me tengo que llamar sucio.
I gotta call myself clean.
Tengo que llamarme limpio.
I don't gotta call myself bound. I gotta call myself free.
Ya yo no tengo que llamarme atada sino que estoy libre.
So he had a positional sanctification. Say positional sanctification.
Él tenía una posición santificada.
But he also had a progressive sanctification. Say progressive sanctification.
Y él también tuvo una santificación progresiva.
Noah lived clean.
Noé vivió limpio.
In the midst of a dirty world.
Entre medio de un mundo sucio.
If you leave that verse number 9 up for me, I appreciate it. Blameless in his generation. And then it says, give me verse number 9
Genesis 6.
Genesis 6, 9. I know. I'm going to give you some money later so you can eat. blameless in his time, that means it was progressive.
Él fue encontrado perfecto en su tiempo.
Noah walked with God.
Eso quiere decir que era progresivo y entonces Noé caminó
con
Dios.
He was going,
entonces en lo que él andaba,
he consistently
él consistentemente
walked blameless.
Estaba caminando perfecto.
It wasn't just a moment thing.
No era solamente algo momentario.
Did y'all catch that? It was something that was continuing.
Sino que era algo continuo.
Okay, all right. Don't think that just because you got saved, you don't have to progressively walk with God.
No vayas a creer que solamente porque fuiste salvo no tienes que caminar progresivamente con Dios.
There's something we got to do as we walk with God.
Hay algo que tenemos que hacer en lo que caminamos con Dios.
Because this generation is dirty, it's filthy, it's aggressive, and it is dark.
Porque esta generación es sucia y oscura y agresiva.
But God is calling us.
Pero Dios nos está llamando.
To live in this world continually.
Para vivir en este mundo continuamente.
With continual cleansing.
Con una limpieza continua.
That's why we shower daily.
Por eso es que nos bañamos diariamente.
I hope
espero
that some of y'all shower daily. That's what we're supposed to do.
Ay. Eso es lo que estamos supuesto hacer.
And the little patch jobs that sometimes we do because we're in a rush, I praise that you did that, but we need to shower daily in the water completely engulfed all over, you know, and allow the soap to literally just process itself in every area of our lives, right?
Continually.
You know, because you walk around not doing that and then you mad that somebody say, you don't smell too good today.
Y entonces si tú caminas no haciendo eso, no te puedes enojar que alguien te vaya a decir que tú no hueles bien hoy.
And I'm about to help some of y'all.
Y voy a ayudar a algunos de ustedes.
Perfume.
El perfume
does not cover
no cubre
that you nasty.
Que eres asqueroso.
Don't you be, you got that little spray bottle talking about, no te preocupes, I got this.
No vayas a sacar el perfume.
It's like the people that haven't washed their hair for like a week, but they got that spray shampoo.
Es como las personas que no se lavan. 1 week is okay, y'all, okay? 1 week?
Sometimes.
Wait, just because you have no hair.
State the obvious. Why are you mad?
Because
you've smelled it. That's why you're mad. I'm saying the truth. So let's go. You gotta continually cleanse yourself in
Him. Limpiarte en él.
In Him.
En él.
continually.
Continuamente.
So you, because this world is bad.
Porque este mundo es
malo. It's aggressive. People get you. You flip somebody in a second.
Es agresivo.
Y'all know what I'm saying, right? Y'all, in a second, y'all flip somebody.
En un segundo pueden hacer algo.
Y'all flip
malo.
Y'all holy finger. It goes in the Holy Ghost. It just falls up. Or you cuss at somebody. In a second, they get you mad. Let
en
somebody
un segundo,
cross
tú
you.
Dejas que alguien te enoje, te pones bravo con ellos, dices malas palabras.
That's why we need continual cleansing.
Por eso es que necesitamos una limpieza continua.
Because the enemy out there trying to mess with you.
Porque el enemigo está allá afuera tratando de hacerte tropezar.
Somebody say progressive.
Alguien decir progresivo.
Somebody say progressive.
Progresivo.
Somebody say progressive.
Progresivo.
As you grow in the Lord, He will be constantly revealing things that need to be made right.
En lo que tú creces en el Señor, él va constantemente va a revelar cosas que tienen que ser arregladas.
So say positional.
Decir posicional.
Say progressive.
Progresivo.
Say perpetual.
Decir
perpetuo.
Perpetuo.
Noah's perpetual sanctification.
La santificación de Noé perpetua.
He walked with.
El caminó con.
God.
Dios.
With. God.
Con Dios.
That's a perpetual sanctification.
Eso es una santificación perpetua.
This is the key to the success of a believer.
Esta es la clave para el éxito de un creyente.
Because the closer we get to Him,
porque lo más cerca, lo más que nos acercamos
the
a
more
él,
we must come to agree with and be like Him.
Lo más tenemos que es ser como él.
There is no way that we can walk with God,
no hay ninguna manera que podemos caminar con Dios,
and not agree with God.
Y no estar de acuerdo con Dios.
Amos chapter 3 verse 3. Do two people walk together unless they have agreed to meet?
Amos capítulo 3 versículo 3. Andad dos hombres juntos si no se han puesto de acuerdo.
So when I walk with God,
entonces cuando yo camino
I'm
con Dios,
I'm telling God I agree with you.
Yo le estoy diciendo a Dios, yo estoy de acuerdo
contigo. I agree
contigo.
With what you want.
Yo estoy de acuerdo con lo que tú
I
quieres.
I agree with what you are saying.
Yo estoy de acuerdo con lo que tú estás diciendo.
So let us land this plane.
Entonces vamos a aterrizar este
avión.
You can
play something
flourish. Flourish.
Flourish. Something
del
flourish.
Diluvio.
In the book of Hebrews, chapter 11, verse 7.
Puedes tocar algo diluvial.
Diluvial.
Asha. Hebreos capítulo
11, versículo 7.
Capítulo
the verse
11,
that we started
versículo
with.
7.
Because we're landing. Mm. By faith, say by faith.
Por la fe.
Noah, being Noé. Warned by God about things not yet seen, in reverence prepared an ark for the salvation of his household, by which he condemned the world and became an heir of the righteousness which is according to faith.
Por la fe, siendo advertido por Dios acerca de cosas que aún no se han visto con temor, preparó un arca para la salvación de su casa, por lo cual condenó al mundo y llegó a ser heredero de la justicia que es según la fe.
So there's three things in this text and we're done, and they're very short. Number one, he had faith.
Número uno, en este texto, él tuvo fe.
If you could leave that text up, I'll appreciate it. Number two, he had fear.
Número tres, tuvo temor.
And number three, he had faithfulness.
Y número tres, tuvo fidelidad.
Okay, he had faith.
Tuvo fe.
He had fear.
Tuvo temor.
And he had faithfulness.
Y tuvo fidelidad.
He had faith because he believed God.
Tuvo fe porque creyó en Dios.
And verse number six, the verse before this verse, it says, and without faith it is impossible to please him.
Y el versículo 6 antes de este dice, y sin fe es imposible agradar a Dios.
For the one who comes to God must believe that he exists and that he proves to be one who rewards those who seek him.
Porque es necesario que el que se acerca a Dios crea en el que él existe y que remure, I can't say the word, y que es remunerador. De los que se buscan.
Okay, sorry about that. You know, you need to have faith.
Tienes que tener fe.
So can I ask you a very simple question? Is do you believe God?
Y te hago una pregunta bien simple. Es que si tú crees en Dios.
If you say yes to that,
si tú le dices sí a eso,
then you got to walk in faith.
Tienes que caminar en fe.
I ask you another question. Is your
pregunta.
God real big or real small?
¿Es tu Dios grande, bien grande o bien pequeño?
If he is real big,
si él es bien grande,
then you need to expect him to do really big things.
Tienes que esperar que él haga cosas bien grandes.
That means he's going to begin to shift some things in your life that look impossible.
Eso quiere decir que él va a cambiar algunas cosas en tu vida que parezcan imposibles.
So he followed.
Entonces él siguió.
The ordinances that God had laid upon his shoulders.
Las ordenanzas que Dios había puesto sobre sus hombros.
God told him to build.
Dios le dijo que construya.
And he had to build in the dark.
Y él tuvo que edificar en la oscuridad.
He had to build in a dark world.
Él tuvo que edificar en un mundo oscuro.
He had to build in a world that God had cast judgment over.
Él tuvo que edificar en un mundo que Dios ya había puesto un juicio
sobre
ello.
He had to build in a world that God was about to destroy.
Él tuvo que construir en un mundo que Dios iba a destruir.
He had to build in a world that people were looking at him, telling him that he is a fool.
Él tuvo que construir en un mundo que las personas le estaban mirando pensando que él era un tonto.
God told them to build.
Dios le dijo que construya.
No one believed that there was a need to build.
Nadie creía que había una necesidad para construir.
But God spoke.
Pero Dios habló.
And when God speaks,
y cuando Dios habla,
no one else has to come to terms with the instructions.
Nadie más tiene que estar de acuerdo con las instrucciones.
Hear me, no one else has to come to terms with his instructions.
Escucha, nadie más tiene que estar de acuerdo con las instrucciones.
You got to get ready to build.
Tienes que prepararte para.
So I ask you a question: can you be trusted with building in the dark? Can you be trusted with building in a season that nobody's looking at you? Can you be trusted that you're going to be okay with not being called upon? Because you're building for a reason. God gave you the instructions for a reason. He separated you for a reason. He anointed you like that for a reason. Can he trust you to build?
¿Puede él confiar en ti para construir?
When everything around you is dark.
Cuando todo a tu alrededor está oscuro.
So he had faith.
Entonces él tuvo fe.
But he also had fear.
Pero él también tuvo temor.
Noah reverenced God.
Noé le dio reverencia a Dios.
In reverence.
En reverencia.
He prepared an ark.
Él preparó una arca.
In reverence,
en reverencia,
in respect, because he knew
con respeto porque él sabía
the one that asked him to build.
Aquel que le pidió que
edifique. That means that I shut up.
Eso quiere decir que yo me callo la boca.
I stop complaining.
Yo paro de quejarme.
Why are you like that? And why are you like that? And why are you so happy? And why are you walking like that? And why are you blessed? And why is that door open for you? I stop complaining because he told me to build and reverently. I'm gonna build.
Porque este está bendecido, porque aquel está bendecido, porque le abrieron la puerta a aquel. ¿Por qué?
I'm gonna build.
Yo voy a seguir edificando en reverencia porque él me dijo que edifique.
I'm gonna build.
Yo voy a edificar.
Even though nobody's looking at me.
Aunque nadie me está mirando.
I'm gonna build because it's my time to build.
Yo voy a edificar porque es mi tiempo de edificar.
I'm gonna build because it's necessary.
Voy a edificar porque es necesario.
I'm gonna build because he's about to call my number.
Y yo voy a construir porque él está por llamar mi nombre.
I'm gonna build because there's people out there that are more qualified.
Yo voy a edificar porque hay personas allá afuera que son más calificadas.
But God's not gonna call them.
Pero Dios no lo va a llamar a ellos.
God's gonna call me.
Dios me va a llamar a mí.
He's going to call you.
Él te va a llamar a
in
ti.
This season, he's going to call
en
you.
Esta temporada, él te va
if
llamar
you choose
a ti.
To build
si tú escoges construir
reverently,
en una manera reverente.
You want to know the power of building reverently?
¿Quieres saber el poder de construir en una manera reverente?
You respect
tú respetas
every part of that build.
Cada parte de esa
that you're building.
De aquello que estás edificando.
You respect every part of it.
Tú respeta toda parte de ella.
You put every effort you got.
Tú pones todo esfuerzo
on building that.
En construir eso.
Because you know that you're doing it unto God.
Porque tú sabes que lo estás haciendo
para
Dios.
You're not doing it for yourself.
No lo estás haciendo para ti mismo.
Ecclesiastes 12:13.
Ecclesiastes 12:13.
The conclusion, when everything has been heard, is fear God. And keep his commandments. Because this applies to every person.
La conclusión cuando todo se ha oído es esta. Teme a Dios y guarda sus mandamientos porque esto concierne a toda persona.
And he had faithfulness.
Y él tuvo fidelidad.
Noah built.
Noé edificó.
And preached.
Y predicó.
For 120 years.
Por 120 años.
And only had his family and a boat.
Y solamente tuvo su familia y un arca.
In the middle of dry land to show for it.
En el medio de una tierra árida para mostrar.
My God. But the key to Noah's success.
Pero la clave del éxito de Noé.
Was his faithfulness to the task.
Fue su fidelidad al trabajo.
How faithful are you?
¿Cuán fiel eres tú?
With your task.
Con tu trabajo.
Can God count on you?
¿Puede Dios contar contigo?
To fulfill your end of the bargain.
Que cumpla lo que te han dicho.
That you will do it without complaining.
Que lo harás sin quejarte.
That you'll do it with full devotion.
Que lo harás con una devoción
that you'll
total.
Do it with all commitment.
Que lo harás con un compromiso total.
That you'll do it without excuses.
Que lo harás sin excusas.
Because sometimes all Noah had to show for was his family, Derek, and a boat.
Porque a veces lo único que Noé tuvo que mostrar era su familia y un arca.
In the dry land.
en una tierra árida.
You know how crazy that is? That you got a whole bunch of animals inside of a boat, your family's in the boat, and you're in the boat just waiting.
¿Tú sabes lo que es eso? ¿Qué locura es esa? Que tú tienes un arca llena de animales y tu familia y tú simplemente esperando.
I guess this is it.
Ya es esto, supongo que es esto.
But then suddenly,
y de repente,
you hear on the outside,
tú escuchas afuera,
a sound hitting the boat.
Un sonido dándole al arca.
And you say, wait a minute.
Y tú dices, espera.
Something's falling.
Algo está cayendo.
Something's falling. We're now covered.
Algo está cayendo, ya estamos cubiertos.
While on the outside, there are people screaming.
En lo que afuera hay personas gritando.
Wondering, can you open the door?
Preguntando a ver si puedes abrir
la
puerta.
Let us in.
Déjanos entrar.
But they don't have access.
Pero no tienen acceso.
To that next season.
A esa próxima temporada.
Because that season was built for them.
Porque esa temporada fue construida para ellos.
Because they were found righteous.
Porque ellos fueron encontrados.
Everyone else on the outside is going to seek help.
Ellos fueron encontrados justos y todo el mundo afuera va a buscar.
But they might not find it.
Buscar ayuda que tal vez no la encuentran.
But this is the season to build.
Pero esta es la temporada para edificar.
Because as you build, those connected to you will be saved.
Porque en lo que tú estás construyendo, aquellos que están conectados a ti van a ser salvos.
The work is in your hands.
La obra y el trabajo está en tus manos.
To fulfill your assignment.
Para cumplir tu tarea.
Are you faithful?
¿Eres tú fiel?
He built.
Él construyó.
When nobody could believe that it was necessary.
Cuando nadie podía creer que era necesario.
Are you capable?
¿Eres tú capaz?
Of remaining faithful.
De permanecer fiel.
When what's around you is telling you.
Cuando lo que está a tu alrededor te está diciendo.
That you should quit.
Que tú debes rendirte.
Are you capable of remaining connected?
¿Eres tú capaz de permanecer conectado?
To his word.
A su palabra.
Even though you are building something.
Aunque tú estás edificando algo.
For something that you've never seen.
Para algo que tú nunca has visto.
Can God trust you with instructions?
¿Puede Dios confiar en ti con instrucciones?
And a word that doesn't make sense to you.
Y una palabra que no tiene sentido para ti.
If your answer is yes.
Si tu respuesta es sí.
Then he's ready.
Entonces él está listo.
To give you what is coming.
Para darte lo que está por venir.
Because when you say yes to that voice,
porque cuando tú le dices sí a esa voz,
when he speaks, it might scare the nonsense out of you.
Cuando él habla, tal vez te asuste.
And you'll be like, what?
Y tú te preguntas cómo.
Because let me tell you, I've always swung hard.
Porque déjeme decirte, yo siempre he dado duro.
I've always swung hard.
Siempre.
I've never wanted to be ordinary.
Yo nunca he querido ser ordinario.
I've always wanted to do things higher.
Yo siempre he querido hacer las cosas bien
altas.
And
it's not because I wanted to supersede someone.
Y no es porque quería ser más alto que otro.
It's because the people around me didn't want to do it.
Sino es porque las personas a mi alrededor no lo querían
and
hacer.
And I said, Lord, I'm here.
Y yo decía, Señor, aquí
I don't
estoy.
Know how to do that though, but if you could help me, I'm going to try.
Yo no sé cómo hacer eso, pero si tú me ayudas,
and
voy a tratar.
Suddenly his favor comes.
Y de repente viene su
and
favor.
Gives me the ability to do something I can't.
Y me da la habilidad de hacer algo que yo no
and
puedo.
I'm telling you this because I believe in a God that will allow you to do something that you're incapable
y
of
te
doing.
Estoy diciendo esto porque yo creo en un Dios que te va a permitir hacer algo en que tú que tal vez creas que no puedas hacer.
Because there are way better people that are more capable.
Porque hay personas que son más capaces.
But they're not available.
Pero no están disponibles.
But if you're available in this hour.
Pero si estás disponible en esta hora.
He's ready to give you secrets.
Él está listo para darte secretos.
He's ready to release unto you the very elements of this season.
Él está listo para darte a ti los elementos de esta
that
temporada.
Number one are going to scare you, but at the same time excite you.
Que el número uno te van a asustar y al mismo tiempo te van a emocionar.
Because you got to prepare and plan.
Porque tienes que preparar y planear.
But you got to keep on praying and seeking.
Pero tienes que seguir orando y buscando.
I'm wondering if there's anybody in this room.
Me pregunto si hay alguien en este lugar.
That is like me.
Que es como yo.
That'll say to themselves.
Que se diría a sí mismo.
Lord, you can trust me.
Señor, puedes confiar en mí.
I'll build in the dark.
Yo edifico en la oscuridad.
I'll build in the dark.
Yo edifico en la oscuridad.
I've been building in the dark.
Yo he estado edificando en la oscuridad.
And it hasn't made any sense, but I've been building because I heard you say something.
No tiene sentido, pero yo sigo edificando y construyendo porque te escuché diciendo
algo.
So
I started building.
Entonces empecé a construir.
And it didn't make sense because I thought I was just building for nothing.
Y no tenía sentido porque creía que estaba edificando sin razón.
But I kept on building because I kept on hearing that word whispering, saying, "Finish, finish, finish."
construyendo porque seguía escuchando esa palabra susurrando diciendo termina, termina.
Finish, 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 finish.
Termina, termina.
Because there's something coming for
porque
you.
Porque hay algo que está por venir.
Because there's an assignment that's coming.
Porque hay una asignación que está por
that
venir.
You need to prepare for.
Pero tienes que prepararte.
As you're wondering, when I finish my chaplaincy, I stay standing if you're standing. I immediately look something else up.
Una vez que terminé la clase de capellán, entonces busqué otra cosa.
So that I can get another certification.
Para recibir otra certificación.
In clinical opportunities.
En unas oportunidades clínicas.
Where they'll give me access to go into hospitals and not just meet patients.
Para ir a tener acceso para ir a los hospitales no solamente para los pacientes.
But be certified to talk to more than patients.
Sino ser certificado para hablar con más que pacientes.
Because God, when He puts something in you.
Porque cuando Dios pone algo dentro de ti.
He says, "How much can I stretch you?"
Él dice cuánto te puedo estirar.
To bring up, to allow you to receive all the capacity that you can gain.
Para permitirte recibir toda la capacidad que puedas tener.
I'm not sitting back.
No me voy a sentar.
Waiting.
Esperando.
I'm out there doing it.
Estoy haciendo.
Because I heard Him whisper.
Porque escuché su susurro.
And I hear Him talking.
Y él lo escucho
and
hablando.
He's saying, "Build, build, build, build."
Y él dice, "Edifica, edifica,
build,
edifica."
Build, 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 build.
Él dice, "Construye, construye, construye."
Because it's coming.
Porque está por venir.
And it's going to be great.
Y va a ser grande.
And it'll be huge.
Y va a ser grande.
But He's looking for some folk.
Pero él está buscando algunas personas.
That'll say, "I'm ready."
Que diga, "Estoy listo."
I'm ready to walk chosen, Abba.
Estoy listo para ser escogido.
I'm ready to walk chosen, Abba.
Estoy listo para caminar escogido,
Padre. I want to be used by you.
Yo quiero ser usado por ti.
I want to be anointed by
quiero
you.
Ser ungido por ti.
I want to receive the secrets of this season.
Quiero recibir los secretos de esta temporada.
If that is you today,
si ese eres tú hoy,
I don't expect it to be everybody.
Yo no espero que sean todos.
But if it was, I'll be blessed.
Pero si sea bendecido,
but
si
if
sea,
you are telling yourself today,
si sean todos, seré bendecido.
He can trust me.
Tú puedes confiar en mí.
You can trust me to build in the dark.
Tú puedes confiar en mí para construir en la oscuridad.
And I'm getting ready to build.
Y me estoy preparando para
in fact, I'm already building.
Además, ya estoy construyendo.
I've been broken and building.
He estado quebrantado y construyendo.
I've been crying and building.
He estado llorando y construyendo.
I've felt lost and building.
Me he sentido perdido y
I've wanted to quit and building.
He querido rendir y entonces estoy
edificando. But I haven't stopped building.
Pero no he parado de edificar.
I've wanted to drop the hammer.
Yo he querido soltar.
El martillo, but
martillo.
I haven't dropped it.
Pero no lo he soltado.
I've hit myself a few times.
Yo me he dado algunas veces.
And it hurt a lot.
Y dolió mucho.
But it didn't stop me from building.
Pero no me paró de construir.
I'm building because I heard you talk.
Estoy construyendo porque te escuché hablar.
And I'm not letting go of this word.
Y yo no voy a soltar esta palabra.
Until I see it come to pass.
Hasta que yo vea que se cumpla.
Until I see it fulfilled in my
hasta
house.
Que yo vea que se cumple en mi casa.
Until I see it fulfilled in my family.
Hasta que yo vea que se cumple en mi familia.
Until I see it fulfilled in my generation.
Hasta que yo vea que se cumple
until I see it fulfilled in my season.
Hasta que yo vea que se cumpla en mi temporada.
Until I see my dreams come to pass.
Hasta que yo vea que mis sueños se cumplen.
Because I know it's an hour.
Porque yo sé que es una hora.
Of provision.
De provisión.
But of secrets.
Y de secretos.
So if you're in this room today and you say,
y si estás en este lugar hoy y tú
I'm
dices,
ready to be trusted.
Estoy listo para que confíen en mí.
I'm ready to be trusted with building in the dark.
Estoy listo para que confíen en mí para edificar en la oscuridad.
I want you to come up to this altar.
Yo quiero que vengas a este altar.
Come up to this altar and you can wear your mask if you want to and or you should. But you know,
you
should wear your mask.
Deben ponerse sus
that
máscaras
is recommended,
si vienen hacia aquí al frente.
You know, just to be safe. But you can come up here and you tell yourself as you stand here.
Ustedes se dicen a sí mismo en lo que están aquí de pies.
I want to build.
Yo quiero edificar.
You know the crazy thing about this moment?
La locura de este momento.
Is that many of you
es que muchos de ustedes
already know
ya saben
what you should be building.
Lo que deben de estar edificando.
And the enemy almost
y el enemigo casi
got you to drop the tools.
Casi te tiene soltando las herramientas.
So that you don't build any longer.
Para que tú no edifiques.
But here you are
pero aquí estás,
telling God you can trust me
diciéndole a Dios, puedes confiar
you can
en
trust
mí.
Me to build in a season of adversity
puedes confiar en mí para edificar en una temporada
you
de
can
adversidad.
Trust me to build in a season of brokenness
puedes confiar en mí para edificar en una temporada de quebrantamiento.
So what I want you to do right now
entonces, lo que yo quiero que tú
is
hagas
I want
ahora
you
mismo,
to open up your mouth
es que yo quiero que tú abras
and I want
tu
you
boca,
begin to call out to God
y empiezas que, quiero que clames
and
a
I
Dios,
want you to declare to him
y quiero que declares
I am available to build.
Estoy disponible para
However you want me to build.
Como quieras que tú quieras que
yo edifique. I will build with reverence.
Yo voy a construir con reverencia.
I will build with faith.
Yo voy a construir con fe.
I will build with tenacity.
Yo voy a construir con tenacidad.
I will build with strength.
Yo voy a construir con poder.
I'm not gonna quit.
Yo no voy a rendirme.
I'm not running from this.
Yo no voy a correr de esto.
I'm not leaving this.
Yo no me voy de esto.
I need to finish.
Yo necesito terminar.
What I have started.
Lo que yo he empezado.
Go ahead and open your mouth.
Abre tu boca.
Fill this altar with your prayer.
Llena este altar con tu
fill
oración.
Fill this altar with your declaration.
Llena este altar con tu
declaración. Go ahead and fill this altar with your declaration.
Llena este altar
whatever
con tu declaración.
Whatever it is that you gotta build.
Lo que sea que tú tengas que construir.
You gotta tell the Lord I'm ready to build it.
Tienes que decirle al Señor estoy listo para
I'm ready to break the stronghold.
Estoy listo para romper las fortalezas.
That wants to hold me.
Que quieran aguantarme.
From believing your word.
De creer tu palabra.
You have said.
Tú has dicho.
That you will care for me.
Que tú me vas a cuidar.
That you will protect me.
Que tú me vas a proteger.
That you will keep me.
Que tú me vas a guardar.
That you will guide me.
Que tú me vas a guiar.
That you've anointed me.
Que tú me has ungido.
I'm here to tell you.
Estoy aquí para decirte.
It's not over.
No se ha terminado.
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 Build.
Edifica.
Build.
Edifica.
Build.
Edifica.
Build.
Edifica.
Build.
Edifica.
Build.
Te estoy dando un minuto más para seguir declarando.
And then I'm going to just pass by you and touch you and right on your forehead with some oil.
Y entonces voy a pasar hacia al lado de ti tocarte con aceite.
And I'm going to declare.
Y voy a declarar.
That God release over you.
Que Dios suelte sobre ti.
The following secrets.
Y desate los secretos.
That are necessary.
Siguientes que son necesarios.
For you to finish the build.
Para que tú termines esa edificación.
For you finish your assignment.
Para que termines tu asignación.
Because your assignment is not over.
Porque tu tarea no ha terminado.
There is more to do.
Hay más que hacer.
There is more to do.
Hay más que hacer.
Come on, declare, declare, declare.
Declarar,
declare,
declarar.
Declare, declare. Let's go, Sam. Let's go. Let's go.
Yeah. Your sovereign hand will be my guide. Where feet may fail and fear surrounds me, you've never failed and you won't start now. So I will call upon your name and keep my eyes above the waves. When oceans rise, my soul will rest in your embrace. For I am yours. You are my
Spirit, lead me when my trust is without borders.
Let me walk upon the waters wherever you will call me. Take me deeper than my ears could ever wander, and my faith will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior. Spirit, lead me when my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the water wherever you will call me. Take me deeper than my fears could ever wander, and my faith will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior. Spirit, lead me when my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon trust is without borders.
Unprecedented release from heaven
de un desate sin precedentes de los cielos
for people
para personas
that are desiring to walk
que desean caminar
in something greater than themselves
en algo más grande que sí mismos.
As he releases it
en lo que lo está desatando,
he's going to release onto us strategies
él nos va a dar, estrategias
to be able to design it
para poder diseñarlo,
to plan it to articulate it
planearlo y articularlo
for this season
para esta temporada.
It's not for the weak
no es para los débiles,
but it's for the brave
sino para los,
and it's
valientes
for the violent
y los violentos.
God is seeking for a people
Dios está buscando un pueblo
that will tell themselves I'm here. For as he releases it, every resource that is needed is released.
Cada recurso que se necesita es dado.
Every door that is required is open.
Cada puerta que es requerida está abierta.
Every piece of heaven that must be open is open.
Cada pedazo de cielo que tiene que estar abierto está abierto.
Every financial blessing that you need is open.
Cada bendición financiera que necesitas está abierta.
Every deliverance that you need is released.
Cada liberación que necesitas está soltada.
For this hour,
para esta hora,
will be bigger,
va a ser más grande.
This hour will be bigger.
Esta hora va a ser más grande.
This hour will be bigger.
Esta hora va a ser más grande.
This hour will be bigger.
Esta hora va a ser más grande.
It's going to be bigger.
Va a ser más grande.
It's going to be bigger than you've ever expected.
Va a ser más grande que lo que esperabas.
It's going to be bigger for your house.
Va a ser más grande para tu
casa.
It's going
to be bigger for this house.
Va a ser más grande para
esta casa. It's going to be bigger for your family.
Va a ser más grande para tu familia.
You know what? I need somebody to get up.
Necesito a alguien que se levante.
And find somebody.
Y encuentre a alguien.
And speak to them right now.
Y hablarle a ellos ahora.
And tell them this season.
Y decirle esta temporada.
That is releasing for us.
Que está siendo soltada para
nosotros. It's about to change everything in our life.
Va a cambiar todo en nuestras vidas.
It's going to change everything.
Va a cambiar todo.
Everything in our job is going to change.
Todo lo que el trabajo va a cambiar.
Our finances are going to change.
Nuestras finanzas van a cambiar.
Our health is going to change.
Nuestra salud va a cambiar.
Our family is going to change.
Nuestra familia va a cambiar.
Come, I dare you to get to somebody.
Yo te reto que vayas a alguien.
And tell somebody.
Y decirle a alguien.
What's about to happen for you.
Que lo que va a pasar por ti.
It's going to change everything.
Va a cambiar todo.
If you love the Lord this morning,
si amas al Señor esta mañana,
or this afternoon, just give the Lord a strong hand clap.
O esta tarde, dale un fuerte aplauso al Señor.
Because it is already the afternoon. Ooh, sit down.
Puedes tomar asiento.
Let me relax, because we can keep on going. It's already 12:30, amen, and we out of line, all right? We
the
gotta
game
finish.
Starts in half an hour.
Yeah, the game starts in an hour, half hour. Listen, it is giving time in the Lord.
Es tiempo de dar en el Señor.
Or in the church. I mean, I don't even know what
en
I'm
iglesia,
saying. But
iglesia.
Let's get ready to give to God.
Vamos a estar listo para darle a Dios.
Remember that you can play something soft, something very soft, very soft. I gotta get that chicken out of my throat. It's like chilling.
A chicken?
It's something. Gallo.
Frog?
Turkey. Something. Remember that last week we talked about an offering.
Recuerden que la semana pasada hablamos de una ofrenda.
A special offering for a church called El León in El Paso, Texas.
Una ofrenda especial para una iglesia que se llama El León en El Paso, Texas.
Because they are servicing so many of the immigration process that's coming to their church.
Porque están dándole servicios a muchas personas inmigrantes que están viniendo a su iglesia.
Today was that special day.
Y hoy es ese día especial.
Remember that we're giving As we give, we're giving our tithe and our offerings.
En lo que estamos dando, estamos dando nuestros diezmos y ofrendas.
Those that are connected on Facebook still.
Aquellos que están conectados en Facebook todavía.
You can click on the link, and when you click on the link, the special offering is going to missions.
Y cuando le da al enlace, la ofrenda especial va a las misiones.
If you're texting to give,
si estás mandando un mensaje de texto,
the short code is missions with an S.
El código sería ND, la cantidad, y entonces missions con una S al final. M-I-S-S-I-O-N-S.
Missions is with two S's. M-I-S-S-I-O-N-S. If you're going to give with cash on the outside, make sure you give an envelope on the side and just write missions and put your name.
Si van a dar en efectivo allá afuera, entonces esté seguro que escriba misiones en el sobre y entonces lo entrega.
We are going to be sending this offering to the office tomorrow.
Esta ofrenda va a ser mandada a las oficinas regionales mañana.
So I thank you as you give. Raise your offering in the air.
Le doy gracias, alza sus ofrendas a los cielos.
And repeat after me, say, Lord,
repita con nosotros, Señor,
receive this seed.
Recibe esta semilla.
In Jesus' name.
En el nombre de Jesús.
Amen.
Amen.
And amen.
Y amen.
Listen, y'all. Yeah, don't forget your actual tithe and offering. We want that too, but everybody in this room that can.
No se olviden de dar también sus diezmos y ofrendas. También deseamos eso, pero aquellos que sí pueden.
That can.
Que sí pueden.
Should give to the mission.
Deben de darle a las misiones.
If it's only a dollar.
Si es solamente un dólar.
I promise you.
Yo le prometo.
God's gonna honor you.
Dios lo va a honrar.
When you give to missions, you honor. God blesses you.
Cuando le dan las misiones, Dios los bendice.
ND amount missions. Yeah, it's the same way as we go. So we thank you as you get Facebook. We love you. I don't know if you already logged off. Love you. Talk to you guys on Wednesday. Deuces.